Hello dear students, welcome to my channel. In this episode we are going to discuss the properties of triangles, exercise 9A. That is, we will discuss the problems related to properties of triangles. In the previous sessions I discussed that the sine rule, cosine rule, tangent rule or Napier analogy and half angle formulae we discussed once you go through that previous sessions. Let us have a discussion on the first problem here. Show that summation A into sin B minus sin C equal to 0. So this is the first question. Now we are going to do that solution. We know that from sine rule, you take that RHS. So now LHS. Sigma or summation A into sin B minus sin C. Sin B minus sin C. From sin rule we have A equal to 2 R sin A, B equal to 2 R sin B and C equal to 2 R sin C, which is also equal to summation A into, in place of sin B, from sin rule we have to write A B by 2R minus, in place of sin C, C by 2R. After that take LCM 2R, summation A by 2R into B minus C. 2R is constant, we can take outside. Of that 1 by 2R summation A into B minus C. If we remove summation in cyclic order, it will becomes 1 by 2R A into B minus C plus B into C minus A plus C into A minus B. If you simplify this, 1 by 2R AB minus AC plus BC minus AB or BA plus CA minus CB or BC plus BC minus BC get cancelled. Minus AC plus AC get cancelled, plus AB minus AB get cancelled. So all are cancelled. So 1 by 2R into 0. 0 into anything is 0, which is equal to RHS. Therefore, conclusion, summation A into sin B minus sin C, which is equal to 0. Here I already said that we applied sine rule. From sine rule we have A is equal to 2R sin A, at the same time B equal to 2R sin B. From that we are taking as a subject sin B. So B by 2R is equal to sin B. Similarly sin C is equal to C by 2R. Let us take that next question. Question number 2. If next question, A equal to small a, length of the side, root 3 plus 1 and the angles, angle B equal to 30 degrees and angle C equal to 45 degrees. Then find small c. then find small c. So here also, this is the application of sine rule. So how we are going to get that? In triangle ABC, we have angle A plus angle B plus angle C equal to 180 degrees. So that implies that except angle A, remaining we have to substitute here, 30 plus 45 is equal to 180. So angle A equal to 180 minus 75, which is equal to 105. Therefore, angle A equal to 105. After getting the value of A, angle A means this, by using sine rule, we have A by sine A, we need to calculate which is equal to B by sine B, but we need to calculate small c, no? So you write it as C by sine C. That implies small a value we have root 3 plus 1 divided by sine A, sine 105 is equal to small c divided by sine C value. Angle C is 45 degrees here. After that, root 3 plus 1 divided by sine of 105 can be written as 180 minus 75, which is equal to C by sine 45, 1 by root 2. That implies that root 3 plus 1 divided by sine of 180 minus theta sine theta. So sine 75, equal to denominator of denominator, it will become a numerator, root C into C. See, after that, which implies that root 3 plus 1 divided by sine 75 degrees equal to root 3 plus 1 divided by 2 root 2. You have to remember that the value of sine 75 is equal to root 3 plus 1 by 2 root 2. You make a note, sine 75 equal to root 3 plus 1 divided by 2 root 2. So now, which is equal to root 2 into C, that is also implies that root 3 plus 1, root 3 plus 1 get cancelled. Denominator of a denominator will become a numerator. 2 root 2 equal to root 2 C, root 2 root 2 get cancelled. C is equal to 2. Therefore, the length of the side small c is equal to 2. The next question. If small a equal to 2 centimeters and b equal to 3 centimeters and small c equal to 4 centimeters, then find cos A. Direct question it is. If you know the cosine rule, you are able to do that answer. We have cosine rule given first. First step according to the examination patterns, step by step you have to write. Given that small a equal to 2 centimeters, small b equal to 3 centimeters and small c equal to 4 centimeters. After that we have formula cos a equal to, whenever cos a they are asking, small a square value will be lost. So we have formula b square plus c square minus a square divided by 2bc. Now substitute the respective values, which is equal to b square, that means 3 square plus 4 square minus 2 square divided by 2 into 3 into 4. Therefore, cos A equal to 9 plus 16 minus 4 divided by 2 3s are 6, 6 4s are 24. So, which is equal to 25 minus 4, 21 divided by 24 by 3 table, 3 7s are 3 8s are. So, 7 by 8. Therefore, the conclusion step, cos A equal to 7 by 8. They are asking to calculate only cos A. Hence, the value cos A. Next question, if small a equal to 26 centimeters and b equal to 30 and cos c equal to, it is indirect question, cos c equal to 63 by 65, then find small c. Then find small c. In this question, A value, B value is there, C value, small c they are asking and including cos c. So, how to do that? Another form of cosine rule we have, first given that A equal to 26 centimeters and B equal to 30 centimeters. And cos C equal to 63 divided by 65. And we have another form of cosine rule. Small c square equal to. Small c square equal to. A square plus B square. Minus 2AB into cos C. This is another form of cosine rule. Substitute the respective values in this. A square, that means 26 whole square, plus B square, 30 whole square, minus 2 into A value 26, B value 30, into cos C value 63 divided by 65. So, 13 table, 13 2s are, 13 5s are, again 5 1s are, 5 6 are, which is equal to 26 whole square, 26 whole square, 676 plus 30 whole square, 900 minus 2 2s are 4, 4 into 6, 24 into 63, which is equal to 676 plus 900, which is equal to 1576, 9 plus 6, 15, 1576, minus 63 into 24, here we have to do that the actual multiplication, so 1512 it is, 24 into 63 is 1512, which is equal to 1576 minus 1512 is 64, so c square equal to 64, c is equal to 8, therefore the value of small c is 8. The next question, if the angles are in the ratio 1:5:6. If the angles are in the ratio 1:5:6, then find the ratio of, then find the ratio of its sides. That means small a is to small b is to small c. They are asking. Here what condition is given? Given that the angles are in the sides, the ratio. Given capital A, A is to B is to C, which represents angles. That values are equal to 1:5:6. The angles are in the ratio 1:5:6. So we can write it as A is to B equal to 1:2 means A by B equal to 1/2. In the similarly, we can write it as A by 1, they are in proportional only, no? So A by 1, which is equal to B by 5, which is equal to C by 6. After that, you can assume this is some constant K. We have to assume that some constant K. After that, by equating these two, you will get the values of A, B, C respectively. A equal to 1:K and B equal to 5:K and C equal to 6:K. So C is equal to 6K. We know that the relation between capital A, B, C, we know the sum of the angles is equal to 180. So we have angle A plus B plus C is equal to 180. So A plus B plus C means you will get K plus 5K plus 6K, which is equal to 180. That implies that 12K is equal to 180. So 12 times of 180 means 15 times it will be cancelled. That implies K is equal to 15. Whenever K value is 15, we can get the values of ABC. Therefore, A equal to 15 degrees and B equal to 5:15, which is equal to 75, and C is equal to 6:15, which is equal to 90. After getting the values of A, B, C, we know that the sides of the triangle are proportional with their sine angles. Sir, how sir you are saying that like this? From sine rule, A by sine A, B by sine B, which is equal to C by sine C, which is equal to 2R. 2R is a constant. 2R constant and also circumradius. Here R represents. Whenever all the values are in these values, A by sine A, B by sine B, C by sine C is equal to 2R, they are in proportional, no? So from this relation, we have to write A is to B is to C is equal to sine A is to sine B is to sine C. So here we wrote, no? A is to B is to C equal to 1:5:6. Then we can write as A by 1, B by 5, C by 6. In the similar procedure, A by sine A, B by sine B, C by sine C can be written as A is to B is to C equal to sine A is to sine B is to sine C. We know the values of A, B, C here. A is equal to sine 15, B is equal to 75, and C is equal to 90. These values substitute here. And sine A, sine 15 is to sine 75 into is to sine 90. We have the values, you remember that throughout trigonometry ends. Sine 15 root 3 minus 1 divided by 2 root 2. Sine 75 root 3 plus 1 by 2 root 2. We know the sine 90 value is, we know that, but still I am writing here. So now substitute respective values. Root 3 minus 1 by 2 root 2 is to root 3 plus 1 by 2 root 2 is to 1. What I am doing is here, in every term denominator is 2 root 2, no? So I want to make the last term also denominator is 2 root 2. So to get denominator 2 root 2 here, multiplying and dividing by 2 root 2 for the last term, it will becomes root 3 minus 1 by 2 root 2 is to root 3 plus 1 by 2 root 2 is to 2 root 2 divided by root 2 root 2. So all the denominator is same, we can cancel it. We can write it as root 3 minus 1 is to root 3 plus 1 is to 2 root 2. Therefore, the ratio of its sides A is to B is to C is root 3 minus 1 is to root 3 plus 1 is to 2 root 2. You have to remember these values, sine 15 and sine 75 and sine 90, we know that, but still we have to remember these values. The next question. Prove that two times of BC cos A plus CA cos B plus AB cos C is equal to A square plus B square plus C square. So now consider LHS two times of BC cos A plus CA cos B plus AB cos C. This also can be written as summation, each and every term multiplying by 2, which is equal to 2BC cos A plus 2CA cos B plus 2AB cos C. After that, we can write as here by using cyclic process. This can be expressed as summation of 2BC cos A. We know the formula for cos A, cosine, by using cosine rule. By cosine rule, summation 2BC into B square plus C square minus A square divided by 2BC. So here 2BC, here 2BC get cancelled. We have summation B square plus C square minus A square. If you do that cyclic procedure here, you will get first BCA, it starts from BCA, you know, B square plus C square minus A square plus, after that start with C, C square plus A square minus B square plus, start with A now, A square plus B square minus C square. So, minus C square plus C square get cancelled, minus A square plus A square get cancelled, plus B square minus B square get cancelled. The rest of the terms, A square plus B square plus C square. Therefore, which is equal to A square plus B square plus C square. This RHS, which is required RHS. The next question. Prove that square plus b square minus c square divided by c square plus a square minus b square, which is equal to tan b divided by tan c. It's very easy problem if you know the formulas. Conditions apply. So now consider LHS. A square plus b square minus c square divided by c square plus a square minus b square, which is equal to, from cosine rule, suppose if you want to write, whenever minus c square is there here, it is equal to the cos c formula will come from cosine rules. Here already in the, here in this question also I discussed here. So this numerator value is 2ab into cos c divided by the denominator value, here minus b square is there, means cos b will come. So 2ca cos b. Sir, how sir you are writing like this? See, the formula for cos c is equal to a square plus b square minus c square divided by 2ab. If you do that cross multiplication, you will get a square plus b square minus c square only, no? So from that, similarly from cos b also, a square plus c square minus b square divided by 2ac. If we do that cross multiplication, you will get the values of a square plus c square minus b square. It should be equal to 2ac cos b. So by using cosine rules, we will get like this. So now we can cancel the values of 2a here. 2 get cancelled, a get cancelled, and b can be written as, the rest of the terms will be b cos c by c cos b, which is also equal to, b can be written as 2r sin b from sine rule into cos c divided by, c can be written as 2r sin c again from sine rule into cos b. So here 2r get cancelled. Sin b by cos b, it will be tan b. After that, cos c by sin c is cot c. So now sin b by cos b into cos c divided by sin c. Sin b by cos b is tan b. Cos c by sin c is cot c. So, but we want to get tan c in the denominator, no? So cot c we can write as 1 by tan c. So which is equal to tan b into 1 by tan c, which is also equal to tan b by tan c, which is required RHS. Hence proved. The next question. Prove that b plus c into cos a plus c plus a into cos b plus a plus b into cos c is equal to a plus b plus c. They are asking to prove that value is a plus b plus c. Now consider LHS. In LHS, b plus c into cos a plus c plus a into cos b plus a plus b into cos c. just you have to multiply. That means actual multiplication is required. That's all. So B into cos A plus C into cos A plus C into cos B plus A into cos B plus A into cos C plus B into cos C. After actual multiplication step, observe carefully. Here we are going to apply the projection formula. See that B cos A and A cos B. First term and fourth term. Next, here C cos A and A cos C. And the rest of the terms, last term and third term. If you write at one place all these values, whatever I kept in the brackets. So first B cos A plus A cos B, bracket close, plus second bracket, second term, C cos A plus A cos C plus remaining last term, C cos B plus B cos C. By using projection rules or from projection rules, we have the first bracket value here, BA is there, means it will become small c, plus here AC is there, small b, that value small b equal to C cos A plus A cos C, plus last one here BC is there, no, small a, which is required or HS by using projection rules. The next question, prove that B minus A cos C into sin A is equal to small a into cos A into sin C. This type of question important for 2 marks. This is also application of projection rule only. See that, consider LHS. B into, so here B minus A cos C into sin A is equal to, in place of small b, from projection rules, we have from projection rule small b equal to, I am writing here, A cos B, A cos A, A cos C, capital C, plus C cos capital A. This is by using projection rule. So similarly, so in place of B here, you have to write this one. So we can write it as A cos C plus C cos A. In place of B, we substituted. Now minus A cos C into sin A, which is equal to, in this, what terms we have to cancel it here? A cos C minus A cos C, you have to cancel it. The rest of the terms, C into cos A into sin A. After that, what we have to do? We know that small c can be written as from sin rule to r sin A, sorry, to r sin C into cos A into sin A. After that, I want to prove here small a in RHS. So small a, how to get? To r sin A, if you take, that value is small a. So 2 r into sin A, we can take as small a, into cos A, into small sin C, which is required or HS. Hence proved, since from sin rule, small a equal to 2 or sin A. The next question, if 4 comma 5 are two sides of the triangle and the angle includes and the angle includes 60 degrees, then find its area. So we know that when two sides is there and one angle is there, we have to apply 2-3 formulas are there. We have anyone you can take. Given sides of a triangle A equal to 4 centimeters and B equal to 5 centimeters and include an angle. Whenever two sides are there, one angle I am taking capital C is equal to 60 degrees. Whenever two sides and angle is there, we have the formula, the area of triangle ABC is delta equal to half AB sin C. Now the respective value substitute, half into 4 into 5 into sin 60, which is equal to half into 4 into 5 into sin 60 root 3 by 2. So here 2 to the 4, here 4 get cancelled, 5 root 3, which is equal to the area of triangle is 5 root 3 square units. The next question, show that B into cos square C by 2 plus small c into cos square b by 2 is equal to s. Show that b cos square c by 2 plus c cos square b by 2 equal to s. These problems are related to triangle only. So if they were mentioned or not, you have to understand that all the problems in properties of triangles you have to consider. Show that the value is given is, so you have to consider it is related to triangle. So in triangle ABC, show that it is. So how to proceed? You have to know about cosine rules, off angle formulas of cos. So now consider LHS. B into cos square C by 2 plus C into cos square B by 2, which is equal to small b into The formula for cos square c by 2, cos c by 2 is square root of s into s minus c divided by ab whole square. So cos square c by 2 is over plus c into cos b by 2 whole square. So cos b by 2 means s into s minus b divided by ac whole square. A root square cancel. We will get b into s into s minus c divided by ab plus c into s into s minus b divided by ac. Here c get cancelled. Here b get cancelled. And observe that in both the denominators a is there. So you take LCM as a. And s into s square minus sc plus s into s square minus sb. S square plus s square is 2s square minus sc minus sb minus s take common b plus c divided by a. We have a plus b plus c is equal to 2s, the perimeter of the triangle. So from that we want only b plus c now here. So b plus c is equal to 2s minus a. So substitute here, you will get 2s square minus s into 2s minus a whole divided by a, which is equal to 2s square minus 2s square plus sa divided by a. Minus 2s square plus 2s square get cancelled. Sa by a, which is equal to sa by a. Aa also get cancelled, which is equal to s, which is required or hs. Hence proved. The next question. If small a by cos a equal to small b by cos b equal to small c by cos c, then show that triangle ABC is an equilateral. So now they are asking to prove by given condition, if A by cos A equal to B by cos B equal to C by cos C, then show that triangle ABC is an equilateral triangle. First, given that, what is given condition? Given that small a by cos A, small b by cos B, small c by cos C. From sine rule, small a, small b, small e values. Small a equal to 2 over sin a. Small b equal to 2 over sin b. And small c equal to 2 over sin c. So these values substitute in that above condition. So 2 over sin a divided by cos a, which is equal to 2 r sin b divided by cos b, which is equal to 2 r sin c divided by cos c. In every term, all are equal, no? So in every term, 2 r will be cancelled. We will get sin a by cos a is tan a. Sin b by cos b is equal to tan b, which is equal to sin c by cos c is tan c. Whenever tan A equal to tan B equal to tan C. We got that A equal to B equal to C. Whenever the tan values are equal, obviously their angles also equal. Whenever angles are equal in the triangle ABC, so we proved that the triangle ABC is an equilateral. Therefore, triangle ABC is an equilateral triangle. Hence proved. Thank you, dear students, for watching my channel. Please do subscribe and share to your friends and relatives. And we will meet in the next video with the other session of questions in the first exercise of properties of triangles. Thank you all.